I'm Netta. Today we're going to be going through a hypothermia situation, practical for the OFC course. So the most important thing right now with COVID and patrol is personal protective equipment. So for us, that means masks and also a mask for the patient. If the patient does not have a mask, we will provide them with one. But we will also be wearing protective safety goggles, which in this case are going to be Toby's sunglasses. And then our PPE latex gloves. So once I have all of those on, I am going to approach the scene. And the first thing I'm going to do is determine if the scene is safe. So I see the patient sitting here. There does not appear to be any obstructions, any skiers coming, anything dangerous. So the scene is safe. Now I'm going to approach the patient, introduce myself, and ask for permission to treat them. So, hi, I'm Netta. I'm with Middlebury Color Ski Patrol. Are you okay? Can I help you?
Yes, I'm very cold.
Very cold, okay. So immediately I see that the patient is able to talk to me and is upright and breathing, which is good. So I'm assessing for ABCDs right now. And the first thing I'm going to do actually is use my emergency blanket because I know that they're shivering and suffering from mild hypothermia. So I am going to put this around Toby immediately because I have it on me. Now I'm going to make a call back to patrol to get resources and extra patrollers to get him down the mountain. So, come in, patrol. This is Netta.
Go, patrol.
I have got a male patient in his early 20s suffering from mild hypothermia. He's shivering. You're on the lower part of the Allen. I'm going to need insulation for him, extra warm blankets, a toboggan for transport, and extra patrollers.
Patrol copy.
Alright, so while I'm waiting for the resources and extra patrollers, I'm going to check his circulation, which is the C of ABCDs, by doing CSM on his hand. So I'm going to check for cap refill, which is good. Can you wiggle your fingers for me? Can you close your eyes quickly? What finger am I touching?
My right ring finger.
Okay, cool. So when I see that CSMs are intact, I'm going to continue to be monitoring for ABCDs and also other signs of hypothermia, like bluish lips, cyanotic skin. And I'm also going to ask the patient, do you get cold often? And how long have you been out here?
I've been out here for probably 30 minutes.
Okay.
No jacket, very cold.
So that's a pretty long time. So we want to be getting the patient down pretty quickly. Now we've got the padding, so we're going to put this under his butt. This is going to help with the conduction directly from the snow, and then extra blankets to put around them for convection. Are you starting to feel warmer, Toby?
A little bit.
Yeah? Okay, that's great. We're going to get you down the hill as fast as possible. So now we would load the patient, get them down the hill, and we would do a full patient assessment in the bottom hut, continue to monitor for ABCDs, and awareness of the patient.